Peter Lynch had an historic run as the fund manager for Fidelity, beating the stock market for 13 years and posting a 29% annualized return for investors. But now, one of the greatest investors of all time says he never recommended people to invest in the stock market. Instead, he's given 7 must-know secrets to investors, rules you need to understand before you invest another dime. I'll walk through those investing rules and then reveal what he means when he says not everyone should invest in stocks. But first, it's been 2 years in planning, but I'm finally ready to announce your opportunity to get a share in the revenue from this channel. I love my Let's Talk Money community and want to offer you the chance to be a partner in it. Through an SEC registered crowdfunding offer, for the first time ever, I'm offering revenue share securities in the Let's Talk Money channel. There is a lot of detail I want to go into here, like how these channel revenue tokens are going to distribute a percentage of all future revenue earned on the channel to you as an investor, but I want to get back to our video. I'll leave a link in the description below for more information. You're going to find all the details here along with a Q&A section to ask and answer all your questions. Make sure you check that out fast though, because the launch was on June 27th and revenue shares are almost sold out already. Lynch is celebrating the 35th anniversary of his book, One Up on Wall Street, a book that changed investing for Main Street investors with 2 million copies sold and the profits all donated to charity. Peter Lynch managed Fidelity's Magellan Fund from 1977 through 1990, making it the best performing mutual fund in the world for 13 years with a 29.2% annualized return. In fact, it was so popular that 1 in every 100 Americans invested in the fund during its tenure. Now in the book, he shared his simple approach to investing, and I recommend every investor read this, but the bombshells Lynch dropped in a recent interview are what really caught my eye. Here, Lynch says the biggest risk to investors these days is the desire to play the market. In fact, he calls that play a dangerous verb in this case. Investors can instantly trade $10,000 in a stock they hear about on the bus or just on social media. He says what is most investors are doing now, buying stocks each week and only to sell them within a month and buy others, isn't investing but gambling. And that itchy trigger finger by investors comes out in the average holding period of stocks in this New York Stock Exchange data. Investors held onto stocks for 6 years on average from the 40s until 1970s, but then something changed. Investors got impatient and are now holding their stocks for less than 6 months. Now, there is actually nothing wrong with that short-term trading, but most investors lose money when they trade in and out of their stocks. That's because while a stock's price over the long term is going to go along with those company earnings, in the shorter periods, even over a couple of years, it's all about that investor sentiment in a stock and many factors outside of a company's control. Case in point, shares of Amazon crashed 95% after the dot-com bust to the 2002 low and struggled for years. It would have been very easy for short-term investors to get frustrated and sell out of the stock, only to miss out on an 1,800% return in less than 10 years and a 50,000% return over the next 2 decades. And the lesson here is just give your stocks the time they need to grow into that reason that you bought them for in the first place. Lynch also talked about his most famous piece of advice, invest in what you know. And I have kind of a love-hate relationship with this advice because it is so misunderstood among investors. A lot of investors think this simply means invest in the companies that make the products you like, as if your devotion to Chunky Chicken Soup means you should invest in shares of Campbell's Soup Company. What Lynch actually means here is that you need a deeper understanding of how a company and its industry works, all developed through research. It's not enough to know that Campbell's Soup makes tasty victuals for the whole family. You need to know the profit margins in the industry, where that supply chain issues come up, and how companies compete, whether on branding or on price. To really know a company, you need to know not just that it's booked faster sales growth than its competitors, but why it's been able to do that, and if it's going to be able to continue to do that. I know, it sounds like a lot of work, and yes, it is so much easier just to open up TikTok or let some Yahoo on YouTube pick a list of stocks for you, but folks, that is not investing. Blindly investing into a stock the day you hear about it online is just a sure way to lose money, and you will never be the better investor I know you can be. So yes, it is a lot of work to do all that research into a company, and it's why a lot of investors only invest in the stocks of companies maybe in a few industries, because that's all the time you have to research. Through that research, you get to really know how an industry works and the one or two companies that have a competitive advantage in it. You invest in those, and then with the rest of your money, you just buy the broad stock market index to get that market return that extra kicker from that handful of individual stocks. So the lesson here is just really understand the businesses behind the stocks you buy, what makes them competitive, and the leaders in their industry. Lynch also talks about how to know when to sell, knowing when a story has run its course. And he doesn't give a lot of detail here, but what most investors don't realize is that 99% of the time, your decision to sell a stock has nothing to do with the stock price. I know that might sound confusing because all you hear online is what price you should sell this stock or that, but listen to this. Lynch gives the example of Walmart. By the time the company was 25 years old, just 6 years after it issued stock, the shares were already up 1,000%, a 10-bagger. That's like the holy grail of returns, right? So should you have taken those profits and sold? Of course not. The shares jumped another 600% in the next decade and have boomed 1,500% in the 30 years since. Now here Lynch goes into an analogy, talks about knowing what inning of the ball game the company is in, which sounds a little like bullshit to me, but there is a point here. At that point, Walmart was still in just 18% of the United States and still had a lot of growth to look forward to. But the point is, it's never the price of the stock that should cause you to sell. Whether the stock price has gone up or down doesn't really change the underlying fundamentals of a company and what your research says about it. That change in the stock price might point to a factor, so if a stock is plunging, then you have to ask yourself if what you believe about the company is wrong, but as long as your long-term reasoning for that stock is still valid, you have to hold on. There are a few legitimate reasons to sell. Those are things like if you just need the money right now, if you have another stock you have more confidence in and are expecting higher returns, maybe if management does something fraudulent or scammy or changes the business model, or if the outlook on the company's long-term potential does change. So the lesson here is you should only be selling your long-term stocks if the business or management changes. If something fundamental about your view of that business changes, not just because of the price. Next, Lynch gives probably the best advice to new investors, or really any investor at all. Here Lynch says if you're going to be picking stocks, and this means investing in those individual stocks and holding them for less than a few years, so not really long-term investing, but more like stock trading, then test out your skills first. There are some great stock simulators online. I use the one on Webull platform, which I'll link to in the description below, where you can start a paper portfolio with $1 million. You pick your stocks and then follow your returns. Since it's play money portfolio, you've got nothing to lose. You're not losing anything, but it gives you the opportunity to see if you're really making money or not. So this is one of the best yet. If you're going to be trading in and out of your stocks, test out your ideas in that paper portfolio first to see how you actually do. There are a couple of great ideas in this next part where Lynch tells how to find those home run companies. First, he recommends buying smaller companies, and then gives the example of buying what would be the future Panera Bread when it was just a $23 million company, an investment he made over 300 times his money when it was sold for $7.5 billion. This is what we talk about in our penny stock video, so those companies under $500 million in market cap. It's just the law of large numbers here, folks. For shares of Apple to even do 10x, the company would have to grow to almost $30 trillion market valuation. That's about a third the entire world's economy. It just ain't gonna happen. But for a company like Graphene Manufacturing Group, a chemicals company trying to find a replacement for lithium and EV batteries at a $145 million market value, even growing to just a $5 billion market cap, puts it at a 3,400% return. He also talks about investing in companies with strong profit margins or turnaround stories, the kind of things you're going to uncover in your analysis when you're researching stocks. Now, these are rarer than even those stocks that you like for the long term. These are the ones where everything seems to fit. They've got that good growth, strong competitive position against peers, and the valuation is just right. Now, this one is tough to do, but a great lesson, looking for those rare home run companies that will boom higher. Lynch then talks about something most investors don't even know is an option, using your gut to know if you should even be buying stocks. And wait now, this is not about using your gut to pick stocks or going on a hunch about an investment. That's just lazy investing. People start talking about having a hunch or a feeling about a stock when really, they just don't want to put in the time and the work to research it and have a real reason to invest or not. No, what Lynch is talking about here when he says investing is not in the brain, it's in the stomach, is are you able to sleep at night when stocks take that 20% dive into a bear market? Does your stomach knot up and all that stress just drive you crazy? Or can you keep your eye on that long term and know that stocks will go up? Because unfortunately, it's the person getting an ulcer over the stock market that's going to panic and sell at exactly the wrong time. They might hold on for a few months, hoping for that rebound, but eventually it's going to be too much and they're going to sell, usually just before things start improving, which is always that big kick in the ass. Now, if that's the case, you're a little high strung and it's totally fine if you are, but you have got to understand that's what happens in stocks, and maybe you should invest in safer assets like bonds or index funds. So the lesson here is just if your stocks are causing you stress, then you shouldn't be in them. Have that confidence in your long-term stocks and just dump the rest. Maybe the most important point in all of this here, where Lynch says the key is that it's fun. Researching stocks is fun. No, he doesn't explain this, but it's something I've talked about here on the channel before. Folks, you need to be getting something out of following the markets and researching those stocks, something more than just the money or the return. It's another point that doesn't seem to make sense, but you're gonna see it's one of the most important lessons when I explain it. Nation, Lynch might have been able to beat the market for 13 years and get that 29% annualized return, but that is far from the average investor. There are investors like Peter Lynch, Warren Buffett, and Bill Miller that just beating the market index by even a few percent a year over the long term, they are lionized as investing gods, but they are one in a million stock pickers. The other 99% of us, myself included, are gonna be lucky if we can eke out that market average or maybe a few percent better once in a while. Add up all the time you spend researching stocks though, hours every week, weeks every year over decades, and that extra percent or two just isn't worth it. Now that is why I say you've got to be getting some enjoyment out of this besides just the money. That challenge of finding the next 10 bagger stock or just exercising your mind going through the financial statements for a company, that other value that you get is the only thing that's gonna make those long hours worth it. I'll reveal what to do instead next, but if you don't get that intrinsic value, the enjoyment from investing, then you shouldn't be investing in individual stocks. So that brings up an important point that frankly, you just don't hear enough people talk about on YouTube, that if you're not getting some kind of enjoyment from following stocks, then there is a better alternative. Nation, I appreciate all of you and love that you're a part of the community here on Let's Talk Money, but I don't want you to feel like you have to invest in individual stocks. And this is what Lynch was talking about when he said he never said to invest in the stock market. He meant that not everyone should be actively investing, picking those individual stocks instead of just investing in the entire stock market. So if you don't get that enjoyment from following stocks and you're not ready to make that commitment to that and the research that it takes, then you should just put your money in a simple index fund strategy, like the video I'll link here. That strategy is going to give you the overall market return in stocks, bonds, and real estate. Make your money work for you, but without all the stress and the risk of trying to pick individual stocks. Click on the video to the right for that simple index fund portfolio, the easiest way to invest. Don't forget to join the Let's Talk Money community by tapping that subscribe button and clicking the bell notification.